taxpayers leaving South Africa, concerns around the feasibility of a basic income grant, and vaccine passports incoming. All of that and more in this week's episode of Free Marketeers News. Hey everybody, Chris here with another Free Marketeers News episode for the week ending 24 September 2021. I hope you're having a good Heritage Day and that you have a good weekend ahead of you. Here with the latest economics and business news items for the past week, we jump in with the risk that South Africa is going to push more wealthy taxpayers to take money out of South Africa. The South African Revenue Service has established a high net worth division focusing on South Africa's wealthiest taxpayers and ensuring they fully comply with the country's laws. However, a survey by services firm PwC shows that many of the country's biggest taxpayers believe the unit is unlikely to make much of a dent in closing the country's tax gap, and that the increased targeting could be the final push for many wealthy taxpayers to instead take their money out of the country. The survey considers corporate taxpayers' experiences with the South African Revenue Service over the last year. A total of 159 companies participated in the survey. Around half of the respondents, 47%, said that the new high net worth unit would assist in closing the tax gap, while 36% said it wouldn't, and 16% of respondents indicated that they believed that the unit would somewhat assist. The respondents noted that although some high net worth individuals are out to avoid or evade tax, SARS can't rely on only a small percentage of taxpayers to close the gap. PwC said, and I quote, "Taxpayers believe that we need to retain the few high net worth individuals we have in South Africa and incentivize them to invest in the country. At the same time, SARS must ensure that they are not driving people out of the country. SARS also needs to increase the number of taxpayers at the bottom end," end quote. Moving on to our second item for the week, a new report raises significant doubts on the sustainability of a basic income grant. This is a report from research firm Intellidex. They say, and I quote, "An expensive grant will have to be funded by very substantial increases in tax," end quote. Given South Africa's high rates of poverty, they also said that a basic income grant, which seeks to raise a large fraction of the poor out of poverty, would have to be very expensive. PwC went on to indicate that they have the impression that many of the reports around the feasibility of a basic income grant don't take into account the complexity of what more tax increases, that sort of effect that those would have on all aspects of the economy. They also said that they believe a basic income grant, as it has been proposed, would pose a significant risk to South Africa's public finances and would be perceived by capital markets as doing so. Our next item for this week, government is forging ahead with vaccine passport plans. The National Coronavirus Command Council will consider an implementation for vaccine passports within the next 2 weeks, so keep an eye on that one. Our next item, South Africa, the only G20 country that will not recover to pre-pandemic levels by 2022. This is according to a forecast by the Economist Intelligence Unit, which is the research and analysis division of the Economist Group. They found that South Africa's economy is the only one among the G20 group of countries that will not achieve pre-COVID-19 levels of growth before 2022. Its latest forecast indicates that the world economy is expected to grow by 5.4%. It expects the South African economy to grow 4.2%. By comparison, the International Monetary Fund expects global growth of 6% and the South African economy to grow by 4%. Some top executives are not optimistic about what lies ahead for South Africa. This was one of the major findings in the latest Institute of Directors in South Africa Sentiment Index, which gauges how South African directors view the current operating climate in the country. The index polls the views of close to 500 directors, mostly in an executive capacity. 59% were executive directors and 41% non-executive directors. The survey was conducted earlier this year, while South Africa was in level 3 lockdown. To quote from the report and from Vikeshni Vandayar, who is the executive of governance and corporate services at the Institute of Directors in South Africa, "To that end, corruption and inadequate government service delivery remain in the top ranked challenges affecting business. Energy security is not much of a concern as it was 2 years ago, but still ranks highly with inadequate, along with inadequate government service delivery, end quote. The most negative sentiments that remain part of directors' concerns. Number one, the level of red tape and its impact on business. Number two, poor consumer confidence. Number three, an overregulated environment, not an unregulated environment. Number four, high tax levels. And number five, a lack of infrastructure development. Ratings agency Fitch has warned that South Africa's fiscal position is not strong enough to open the spending taps. A robust economic recovery and better than forecast tax collection has boosted South Africa's chances of achieving fiscal consolidation aims. This is according to Fitch, even as it warned this might not be sustained. This has also not created space for the government to meet new demands that it increases spending. In a statement on Tuesday, Fitch, which of course rates South Africa's foreign debt three notches into sub-investment grade with a negative outlook, said it raised its forecast for economic growth in 2021 to 5.3%. Speaking of 5.3%, our last news item for this week, the South African Reserve Bank has kept the repo rate unchanged at 3.5%. The bank revised the growth outlook from 4.2% to 5.3%. So the South African Reserve Bank and Fitch in agreement in their forecasts for what they think the South African economy will grow by through this year. And with that, we will wrap up this week's episode. I hope you've enjoyed it and found it useful. If you haven't yet, please like the video before you leave, and also remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel. I hope all of you have a great long weekend. Take care out there, and we'll talk to you all again very soon. Until next time, bye-bye.